do what I want. You ain't the boss of me.
Okay, this is module 14 of the 15 module course for HACCP Intermediate Level 3. The last one, 15, will be 10 multiple choice questions. So look out for those on the last video. So enjoy this last informational video. The last module, module 14, is documentation in the HACCP Intermediate course, and it's principle 7 of the HACCP system, to establish documentation. And the aim of this unit is to understand how to establish documentation concerning all procedures and records appropriate to these principles and their application. Learning outcomes: by the end of this unit, you will be able to explain the need for documentation of HACCP systems, name the different types of documentation required to support the HACCP plan, explain how to store completed records, identify the need for keeping documentation up to date and removing obsolete instructions. So documentation is essential to the application of the HACCP system. It must be appropriate to the size and nature of the business and is required for company policy, verification and internal audits, complaint, illness investigation, due diligence, legal compliance, external auditors and environmental health officers or practitioners. Documentation to support the HACCP study. You need the HACCP plan, which I'll go to in a second, and I'll explain what the HACCP plan is. The floor plan, prerequisite programs, audit reports of suppliers, monitoring records of deliveries, specifications, CCP monitoring activities, deviations, corrective actions, audit reports of operation, customer complaints, monitoring activities from prerequisite programs, and all monitoring records must be signed and dated. The HACCP plan, as I mentioned at the beginning, is really all about the HACCP team and the responsibilities, the scope and terms of reference, product, process description, flow diagrams, consumers, hazard analysis and CCP determination, critical limits and targets, deviations and corrective actions, monitoring and record keeping procedures, reasons for critical decisions and modifications, and validation, verification and review procedures. Failure in implementing HACCP could be down to poor hygiene practices, which are prerequisites as we looked at in an earlier module, lack of management commitment, externally imposed, lack of resources, too complex, not understood, lack of knowledge, training, poor records, too much paperwork, system sits in manager's office, too many critical control points, unreliable critical limits. So, just to tidy up then the key points there, we looked at the need for documentation of HACCP systems, the different types of documentation required to support the HACCP plan, how to store completed records, the need for keeping documentation up to date, and removing obsolete instructions. So let's recap. This course I've uploaded comes in 14 parts. I believe the first and second parts were together as one video. But let's look at what we've covered over the 14 lectures. Lecture 1 was a course introduction and an understanding of food safety. Module 2, we looked at hazards. And the key points, which I'll go through with each module, were the biological, physical and chemical hazards relevant to food safety. Module 3 was all about prerequisite programs. And the key points, we looked at control measures, the relationship between HACCP and prerequisite programs, examples of prerequisite programs, the importance of management commitment to implement HACCP, and to provide leadership and resources. and the importance of approved suppliers and supplier assurance. That took us on to Module 4, Legal Requirements and HACCP Principles. And the key points for that module, we looked at hazard analysis, the 7 principles of HACCP, the advantages of a food safety management system based on HACCP principles, the rules of employees or managers regarding food safety and HACCP. That took us on to Module 5, preparing for implementation. And the key points covered the steps involved in the implementation of HACCP based on Codex Alimentarius, the need for a multidisciplinary approach when appointing the HACCP team, the sources of information available to the HACCP team, the product, recipe and process, and why it's important to identify the likely customers. Then we looked at Module 6, Flow Diagrams. And the key points we covered were flow diagrams, how to construct a flow diagram, and the importance of validating a flow diagram. In other words, walking the talk. That took us on to Module 7, Hazard Analysis. And the key points we covered included risk and risk assessment, how to conduct a hazard analysis, the risk that a hazard may occur, the severity of a hazard. Then, Module 8 took us to control measures. Now, the key points covered such areas as control measures, the parameters to which controls can be applied, measures which effectively control hazards included genetic control measures. Then, we looked at Module 9, which was critical control points, and that's Principle 2 of HACCP, to determine the critical control points. And the key points we looked at were critical control points, how to identify CCPs, why resources must be concentrated at the CCPs, and the difference between a critical control point and a control point, which is a good hygiene practice. Then, Module 10, critical limits, target levels and tolerances. The key points covered critical limit, target level, tolerance and deviation. Critical limits and target levels for critical control points, and examples of critical limits and target levels. Then Module 11, monitoring. And here we looked at monitoring, the need for monitoring, the methods of monitoring CCPs, the requirements of monitoring systems, and the knowledge, training and competency of staff with regard to monitoring. Module 12, corrective actions. Key points included deviation and corrective action, the need for corrective action when a critical limit is breached, the formulation and implementation of corrective action, how to deal with products subject to deviation, the need for traceability and recall. Then Module 13, which is the Principle 6, of HACCP to establish verification procedures. And the key points of verification included verification, validation, review and maintenance, the need to verify the HACCP system, what is involved with verification of the HACCP system, the types of audits, the need to validate elements of the HACCP plan to ensure they're effective, the need to update and maintain the HACCP plan. And that took us on to the last module, Module 14, Documentation, which is Principle 7, Established Documentation. And the key points we covered were the need for documentation of HACCP systems, the different types of documentation required to support the HACCP plan, how to store completed records, the need for keeping documentation up to date and removing obsolete instructions. Now, although there's 40 modules, I will be doing a 15th module, which will have some questions from the Level 3 Intermediate course. They're multiple choice questions, and you could have a look at them and see if you can answer them after going through this course.